Good morning, class 7. Welcome for today's lesson. This is teacher Paul Ndirangu, and today we are going to look at steel resources and economic activities, and under subtopic forestry. So we are going to look at forestry. As we know, this is not something new. It is a topic you have handled since class 3, class 4, class 5, even class 6. You are always looking at forestry. So, we are going to look at forestry in DRC Congo. We are going to look at two forests. Forestry in DRC Congo and forestry in Swaziland. And in Swaziland, we are going to look at planted forest. Planted forest, which represent that category of planted forest. And then in forestry in DRC Congo, it represent the natural forest, or what you call indigenous forest. So we start with the forestry in DRC Congo. So before you come to more details on forestry in DRC Congo, we can look at what is forestry itself. So forestry refers to planting and taking care of trees. If you have a large tract of land and you decide to plant very many trees to form a large cover of forest, and then you take care of those trees, you prune them, you water them, you prevent them from being attacked by wild animals or human beings, then we say that one is forestry. Then you have a forest is an extensive piece of land under trees. An extensive means a large tract of land where trees are planted. Okay, maybe in class 4 or 5 you talked about many trees growing together makes a forest. Yes, they do make a forest, but the land must be very big, the land must be very huge. So forest growing on its own is natural or indigenous forest, and then forest grown by man is man-made or planted forest. The one we plant, the one we grew, tunapanda sisi wenyewe, that is planted forest. So trees in natural forest are indigenous. Indigenous means found in our natural environment. Whatever is found in our natural environment, that one is indigenous. For example, you have mahogany, mvule, ebony, camphor, teak, and oak. Those are indigenous trees. They are found naturally within our environment since God created the world. Then we have species in planted forest are called exotic. Exotic means brought from outside, i.e. we have pine, fir, cypress, spruce, cedar, jacaranda, eucalyptus, gravella. So those ones were brought. Exotic means something brought from outside. What is brought from outside? Maybe by Europeans, majorly by Europeans, or even today. You can get some species of trees from other countries all over the world, and then you bring them. Then we continue. In DRC, the main forest is Equatorial Forest. It is the main forest. The Equatorial Forest is the main forest because it grows along the equator, along the Equatorial region. That region experiences hot and wet climate. It experiences very high rainfall and very high temperatures across the year. So the trees grow very fast. So Equatorial Forest, it is the second largest in Africa. I mean, it is the largest in Africa, but the second largest in the world from Amazon forest in Brazil. So the largest forest in Africa, in the world, is Amazon forest in Brazil, followed by the Equatorial Forest, that is the DRC Congo forest. So you find that trees are mainly hardwoods. Trees are mainly hardwood. They produce very hard tree, not the soft wood. Zinatoa ile mbao ngumu ngumu. Then trees take long to mature. They can take over 50, 60, 70 years to mature. They take grow very slowly, slowly, slowly. Then trees have large trunks. Trees have large trunks. Trunk, it is that stem. And because they are very long in height, those now we call them the trunks. So they are very large of them. You can't even put your arms together. So they are very large. Then trees grow to a height of over 70 meters. That tree can grow to a height of over. So it can be even 120. So it is very long. When you cut that tree here in Mansur, it can fall at Al-Hidayah. Then trees form an umbrella shape at top called canopy. So canopy is that umbrella shape because the trees at the top, the branches are intact together. The branches imeshikana pamoja. So that means that they form umbrella shape. They form an umbrella shape called canopy at the top. Then trees have buttress roots. Since these trees, they don't have their roots are very shallow. Hiyo mizizi yake haijaenda chini sana. Because of enough water, the trees do not go very deep. So what happens? The trees develop some roots on the stems and the branches, which go to the ground to provide support. These trees grow very tall, they grow very long, high, so they need support to the sides. They need support because they are normal roots. Their tap roots don't go very deep. So that's why they develop buttress roots for support. There is little or no undergrowth. Undergrowth means the grass that grows on the surface of the tree. Why is it little or no? Because the canopies cover the ground, preventing sunlight from reaching the soil or the ground. So if the sunlight does not reach the ground, which is very wet, then plants. Then harvesting of trees is difficult as trees grow close together. Those trees are very close, very, 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 very close together. Kupenya penya, penetrating inside the forest is very difficult. So it cannot easily be harvested. Then even some areas where the trees are harvested, the logs are very big. They cannot be transported by vehicle. So they are floated in River Congo down due to lack of roads. They are floated in River Congo because they are very long. And they can't be carried by vehicles because there is no transportation system there. So they are floated. Zinabebwa na maji to the mouth of River Congo, where now they are collected at the beach of the Atlantic Ocean. So trees species are camphor, obeche, balia, ebony, oak, greenheart, mahogany, sapele, rosewood, teak, mvule. Those are examples of tree species that grow in Congo forest. Then infrastructure, that is roads, is hindered. Because the trees grow close together, thus penetrating in the forest is very difficult. So those trees have grown together, very close together. Kutengeneza barabara is very difficult. And that is why when they are harvested, those stems zinakatwakatwa, zinatumbukizwa ndani ya mto Congo, where they are carried by water downstream to the mouth of River Congo. Na zikifika hapo sasa, they are loaded to the rollies and taken to the industry for processing of manufacturing of paper. So that is forestry in in DRC Congo. And in the next lesson, we are going to look at forestry in Swaziland. And if you shall have time, you are going to look at problems and the benefits of forestry in DRC Congo and So this was Teacher Paul. Have a good day. Until we meet in the next lesson, goodbye.